Welcome to an ancient DNA paper review by Sebastian Tomek. Today we will look on the population history of the Eurasian steppe after the Bronze Age migration by reviewing the paper 137 ancient human genomes from across the Eurasian steppes in Nature, where they have sequenced the genomes of 137 ancient humans covering a period of 4,000 years that paints a picture of the genomic history of the Eurasian steppes. The steppes stretches about 8,000 km from Hungary in the west to Mongolia and northeastern China in the east, and has been the beating heart of migration of peoples throughout history. Between about 800 and 200 BC, the Eurasian steppes became dominated by Iranian-speaking Scythians. This confederation was divided into geographically distinct groups, but was united by similarities in cultural expression. There are three competing models for the origin of the Scythians. One, the Scythians deriving from a single source originating on the Pontic steppe. Two, an origin in southern Siberia or eastern Central Asia, moving westwards. And finally, three, the Scythians being a product of multiple transitions taking place locally, involving social and cultural borrowing in combination with gradual small-scale human movements. Using PCA and admixture analysis, the researchers have observed a clear separation between two groups of Iron Age Scythians, the Hungarian Scythians and the Inner Asian Sakas. Furthermore, there is a fine-grained structure within the Inner Asia Sakas that separates 1. The population associated with the Tagar culture of southern Siberia, 2. The central Sakas of the central steppe belonging to the Tasmola culture, and 3. The Tian Shan Sakas of the Tian Shan mountain range. These differences reflect the confederal nature of the Scythian organization. The researchers find that Hungarian Scythians had relatively increased European farmer ancestry and shows no signs of gene flow from Inner Asian groups. The Central Sakas can be modeled as a simple two-way mixture of late Bronze Age pastoralists and southern Siberian hunter-gatherers, with almost equal proportions of Bronze Age herders and southern Siberian hunter-gatherer ancestry. The southern Siberian Tagar shows unequal ancestry contribution from Bronze Age herders, more than 80%, and southern Siberian hunter-gatherers, as well as an additional contribution of Malta, ancient North Eurasian-like ancestry of about 10% each, indicating differences in the sources of hunter-gatherer admixture across the Sakas. The Saka population of the Tian Shan mountains displays a high proportion of late Bronze Age steppe herder ancestry, about 70%, followed by southern Siberian hunter-gatherer ancestry, 1/4, with the remainder coming from sources related to a Neolithic population from Iran. This, taken together, indicates admixture between population of late Bronze Age herder descent and various local groups, consistent with the multiple origin model, Model 3, as mentioned earlier. But the Scythians were to be replaced by Turkic-speaking peoples from the east. Turkic language elements arguably first emerged among the Xiongnu nomads, a confederation of several nomadic tribes who occupied the eastern steppes from the 3rd century BC, believed to be of East Asian ancestry. The Huns, 3rd to 5th century AD, have previously been argued to derive directly from the Xiongnu, although others have claimed that there is no evidence connecting the two groups. It is commonly believed that the Huns spread westward, disseminating Turkic languages throughout Central Asia at the cost of Iranian languages. Principal component analysis and these statistics suggest that the Xiongnu individuals belong to two distinct groups, one being of East Asian origin and the other presenting a considerable admixture level with West Eurasian sources. In the figure, these are labeled Xiongnu and Western Xiongnu, respectively. They find that central Sakas are accepted as a source for these Western admixed Xiongnu in a single wave model. They also tested for patterns of shared drift between Xiongnu and the Wu Sun, the preceding Sakas and the slightly later Hans from the 2nd century AD. They find that both the earlier Sakas and the later Hans have more East Asian ancestry than the Wu Sun did. The Wu Sun originally lived between the Xilian Mountains and Duhuang in Gansu, near the Yuezhi, being an eastern remnant of the Indo-Aryans. The genomic data in this paper confirms this, concluding that Wu Sun and Kangyu groups are descendants of Bronze Age pastoralists that interacted with the civilization of Bactria Magna archaeological complex in southern Uzbekistan and eastern Turkmenistan, but yet remained much less admixed with East Asians than did the Iron Age steppe Sakas. Overall, the Xiongnu confederation was genetically homogeneous, and the Han emerged following minor male-driven Eastern Asian gene flow into the preceding Sakas that they invaded. As such, the result supports the contention that the disappearance of the Inner Asian Scythians and Sakas around 2000 years ago was a cultural transmission that coincided with the westward migrations of the Xiongnu. This Xiongnu invasion also led to the displacement of isolated remnant groups related to the late Bronze Age pastoralists that had remained on the southeastern side of the Tian Shan Mountains. In the 6th century, the Hunnic Empire had been broken up and dispersed as Turkic khanate assumed the military and political domination of the steppes. Khanates were steppe-normed political organizations that varied in size and became dominant during this period. They can be contrasted to the previous stateless organization of the Iron Age. The Turkic khanates were eventually replaced by a number of short-lived steppe cultures. These short-lived khanates were then overtaken by the Mongol Empire, which emerged through the unification of Eastern Mongolian and Transbaikalian tribes, and which expanded considerably during the rule of Genghis Khan in the 13th century. They find evidence that elite soldiers associated with the Turkic Khanate are genetically closer to East Asians than are the preceding Huns of the Tian Shan Mountains. During the medieval period, steppe populations were exposed to a gradual admixture from the east, while interacting with incoming West Eurasians. This paper then dwells on the spread of the Justinian plague. We will handle that topic as part of a separate review. That is all for today. Thank you for listening. Till next time, I wish you all the best.